I've been a fan of these 20 mil tubes of Amsterdam acrylic paints for a long time, and with 90 colors in the line, I always find some fun combinations to create with. We're debuting the open stock range today and have put them on introductory sale priced at 25% off. In today's video, I'll show you a couple of options for using them, including with our Joggles foam stamps, plus some simple Brayer backgrounds. You'll find links to the products in the description below. These are the 20mm tubes of Amsterdam acrylic paint. They're a really sweet size. 20mm is equivalent to about 2/3 of an ounce. Now, with the exception of the metallics, the paint dries to a matte finish, so you can come back and write on them with many different types of paint and other pens. Included in the Amsterdam acrylic line are those matte colors, plus the metallics I mentioned. Then there are reflexes, which are neons, and pearls that are interference colors that work best on black and dark surfaces. So this is acrylic paint, which means there are all kinds of techniques that you can use with it. For today, I'm going to show you, and in fact, everything I do today is going to be brayered on, whether I'm brayering on a foam stamp, which is the first thing I'm going to show you, or I'm going to show you how I brayer on a couple of different kinds of backgrounds. And when I'm working on the foam stamps, I'm also going to show you how I use my dip and dab technique to kind of pick up what's left on the table so that it doesn't go to waste. Just briefly, these samples. This is one of our number 8 black smooth and sturdy tags. This was done with Rebekah, Meier's paper leaves foam stamp. And you can see that I blended two what are technically complementary colors. They're across from one another on the color wheel, but I blended them in such a way so that I got some overlap without muddying up the colors. This is Keren Tamir's. This is her distressed flower stamp. You can see that I've stamped it 3 times. Our eyes like odd numbers, and I've done it that way to create kind of an interesting background. There's room to journal in here. There's lots of different things that you can do. This number 8, this is a, I have to feel this. This is a watercolor tag, and the reason I'm feeling it is because sometimes visually it's a little hard. This is smooth and sturdy, and this is watercolor, but I can tell the difference by the feel, and you will too, because smooth and sturdy is super smooth, and this is cold press watercolor paper, so there's a little bit of texture. Okay, coming back to the stamp, this is Elizabeth St. Hilaire's Megan foam stamp, again, 3 times. This is a 5x5 white smooth and sturdy page, and this is Kat Kerr's Grunge Rounds stamp. One stamp, someplace it's here, someplace I had it, and now it's gone. But this is one impression of the stamp, and I'm going to show you this particular ombre technique. I'll show you on a background, but brayering on the stamp would essentially get you to the same place. So with all of that said, I'm going to show you, this is our Blossom stamp, and I'm going to grab these two colors and kind of push all the rest of this out of the way, and I'm going to show you how I use, this is the small Ranger brayer, I'm going to show you how I use this brayer to apply the color, and in this case I'm doing it fairly randomly, but as I said, you can be far more deliberate with a brayer when you apply the color if you so choose to. So with that said, I'm going to put out some of the color, and I'm sure it'll be more than what I really need, but that's where the dip and dab technique comes in. And I've got, this is a white smooth and sturdy page, so I'm going to kind of probably just stamp it once in the middle just to keep this simple. So I'm going to go along and apply some of the turquoise. And now I'm going to come in and I'm going to apply some of the pink. So I'm overlapping, but I'm trying not to do too much blending. Ultimately, this is going to end up probably a little bit more purple as I keep going and adding color, but because as I re-ink, if you will, and I come back, you'll see that, well, I was just going to do this once, but ultimately what happens, and I have another sample here that I can show you. So I'm going to stamp this once kind of in the center of the page, which is not what I normally do, but I'm trying to keep it simple. And there you go. You can see the various colors. Now on this one, I came back and here's my first stamp. And then this was, I think this was the second, and you can see that I've got less pink and turquoise and a little bit more blending that creates a purple. So depending on how many times you might ink that same foam stamp, you're going to see the colors change a little bit. That's just part of the process, and that's part of the serendipity that happens. So I have paint on this stamp. I'm going to spray the stamp, and then I'm going to put a puddle of water on my nonstick craft sheet, and I'm going to put that stamp in it face down. I'm also going to stamp this brayer so that the color doesn't dry on there. And now what I'm going to do, so I have several backgrounds going here. This one is a 3x3, that's already done. So here is a 4x4 black smooth and sturdy dip and dab. All I'm doing is dipping and dabbing the color in there and just getting a background on there. When I do this, it's with the intent that all I'm doing is using up paint that's left. Well, and I'm getting my fingers in it now, so let's turn this over and see if we can pick up a little bit on here just to put a whole nother layer on since my fingers got in there. But you can see when you do this that you get these, let's get rid of this, you get these really cool backgrounds that, whoops, there's nothing on there, is there? That they're just ready to go. You can come in and you can start to add layers, and they work on pretty much all, well, not pretty much, they work on any surface, and you get all kinds of fun effects, and then they're ready to come in and add some other layers. You can start collaging things. You can pretty much do whatever you want. Up next, I'm going to show you how to do brayered backgrounds, and then we're going to give you a couple of different looks depending on, again, how you apply the color to the brayer. Applying paint with a brayer is pretty straightforward, though you can, as I showed you a moment ago, create patterns easily depending on how the colors rolled onto the brayer. Or if you're thoughtful about how much paint you use and how it's applied, you can create more of an all-over look like this, and this is actually what I'm going to show you first. So this is my variation on a technique that I saw Leandra at, from Paper Artsy Demo years ago. Very little paint, the crux here, very little paint that you apply either horizontally or vertically. You don't do any diagonals, and it creates a really nice look. So the key is, as I said, twofold. It's going to be very little paint. So this is a 4x4 white, smooth and sturdy. I tend to start with the lightest color, quite honestly. I don't think it matters, but very, very little paint. You can always come back and use more if you need to. And this is a pretty small page. So my goal here is to get this color rolled out so that it's not going to ever really be a thick application. And I'm going to roll it out when I apply it to the page so that it kind of smooths all of the color out. Now I'm going to just quickly wipe this off and I'm going to wipe this up. Even though I'm going to apply green next, it's really not going to matter because this was such a light application that it's going to be almost dry by the time the green is on there, or the green gets on there. All right, that's probably enough green. And you can always come back and add additional layers. Nothing says this first one is all you're allowed. So again, I'm sticking to horizontal and vertical. There's no diagonal movement going on here with the brayer, though there certainly are times when I might be tempted to do that. Whoops. All right, again, I'm just going to kind of knock the color off the brayer. Now that was a little bit heavy right there, so I'm just going to kind of roll it out. And now I'm going to come back with the turquoise. I like this look. I think it's a brilliant idea, and kudos to Leander for developing it. Again, I'm going to roll this color out so that I'm going to get a very light application. And because the turquoise is fairly dark, I'm probably going to leave it at this. I'm not going to add any more. She says as she adds more, I'm pretty satisfied with the way that that looks. Now, I could dip and dab the rest of this, but there really isn't all that much here. So what happens if, now this has got a lot more white space showing through it than this one does. If I wanted to come back and add more pink and close up some of that white space, I certainly could do that. So what happens if you apply paint a little bit heavier? So this is a 4x4 black, smooth and sturdy. I'm going to grab the same colors again because they're handy, but this time I'm going to very deliberately use more paint. And what that's going to do is add some texture. You can already see the texture that is in here and that's on the brayer, and you can see that if I roll that on, see how all that texture happens? It's automatic. You don't have to do anything. It's pretty darn awesome. And so the process is going to be much the same. I'm going to avoid the diagonals, and I'm just going to go horizontally and vertically. Now I'm only going to use two colors here just for the sake of brevity. I'll come back with the green. The other thing that I like is the fact that the black changes the entire complexion of things, and that's one of the things that I enjoy most about working with black, is that that underlying darkness alters everything and makes it kind of mysterious, kind of cool and interesting. All right, now I think that's enough. I could, if I came back with the pink, I think it would be great, but I'm not going to take the time to do that now. I'm just going to lightly clean off my brayer, and now I'm going to turn my attention to putting colors on to create an ombre. I have paint all over my finger, so let's grab a piece of paper towel. All right, and let's just come back to this. This is kind of the refresher. What I did here was I used two colors, and can I actually find them? There's this. And it might be this blue, I'm not entirely certain, but that's the blue I'm going to use. So what I'm going to do is show you how to do this. Let's grab, what do we got here? Well, let's grab a 5x5 white smooth and sturdy. We're going to do a black because that's the first thing I can put my hands on. But I'm going to switch this out because this color is going to be too dark. And if I do that, you're not going to see it as well. So what I'm going to do is put some paint down. Now this is probably way more paint than I need, but that's all right. I'm going to put these fairly close together so that when I roll the brayer through one, I'm actually going to pick them both up. And I'm going to very deliberately continue to roll this brayer through the paint, and there's a lot of paint on here, until I start to get that blend in the middle, and you can see some purple starting to form. So what I can do is, if I roll this, and I'm going to show you, this is how I achieve this. Now again, the difference is I brayered it onto the foam stamp, but this is the exact process. So I'm going to put the color on, and that kind of went crooked. I'm going to come back and I'm going to re-ink and I'm going to turn so that my color mixes in the middle, or my color joins in the middle. You can see that I go purple, blue, blue, purple, and that's two passes of the brayer. And you can see how that happens. There's pink, blue, blue, pink. Now, if I don't turn this and I come back, what I'm going to get now is an alternating color like this. So how you apply this, and as you play and experiment with these things, how you apply it is very much going to determine the final outcome. Now, there's more than enough here to dip and dab, which I will do after the fact. But with that said, these are the Amsterdam acrylics. Marvelous little tubes of paint. As I said, 20 mil is about 2/3 of an ounce. These are those paints now available at joggles.com, an introductory sale priced at 25% off.